Jerry Mock, a wife and mother of three, dreamed of flying. Always having had a love of aviation, she attended Ohio State to study aeronautical engineering. One evening during dinner, she complained to her husband, Russell, about having nothing to occupy her time and expressed an interest to fly somewhere. Almost as a joke, Russell replied, "Why don't you fly around the world?" Jerry spent the next 15 months planning her historic trip. In the early years of aviation, world travel for aircraft consisted of flying over land and transporting the planes on ships to cross oceans. In 1924, the U.S. Army successfully sent a team of four airplanes for the premier flight around the world. By 1937, Amelia Earhart became the first woman to attempt world travel by air. Tragically, she was lost at sea. Jerry understood the importance of having a solid flight plan. In order to effectively plan her route, Jerry obtained the assistance of the United States Air Force. Captain Weiner was essential in assisting Jerry's overseas planning by providing transcripts in order to communicate with air traffic control along the way. Public interest arose when Jerry began her flight preparations. She earned the nickname, the Flying Housewife. 2 weeks before she was scheduled to leave, Jerry learned of another woman who was also planning a solo flight around the world. Coincidentally, they were both scheduled to leave the same week. The press dubbed this as a race to the finish, understanding the historic significance to see who could complete the journey first. March 19, 1964, Jerry began her journey in the Spirit of Columbus, a Cessna 180, single engine, 225 horsepower tail dragger. As she arrived for her initial departure, emotions overcame her. She paused briefly before entering the runway. The sight of the press and her supporters encouraged her spirit, and she confidently throttled forward. Her liftoff was only the beginning of her grand adventure. She left from Columbus, Ohio, heading to Bermuda for her first stopover along the way. She flew over the ocean for the first time and into the Bermuda Triangle after hearing the tower say, "Well, I guess that's the last we'll hear of her." Jerry made it safely and spent a week grounded in Bermuda, thanks to foul weather over the Atlantic Ocean. Her husband, Russell, urged her to continue on. After all, the sponsors were counting on her beating the other woman, Joan Merriam Smith, in the race around the world. Jerry didn't care about the race. In fact, she would have far preferred there were no sanctions or officials involved at all. She was taking this adventure to see the world, not make headlines or earn herself a title. Jerry made the entire flight wearing a long skirt and high heels. She remarked, "Nobody was going to tell me I couldn't do it because I was a woman." Jerry's exciting 29-day adventure is chronicled in her autobiography, 38 Charlie. Her plane is on display in D.C. at the Smithsonian National Air and Space Museum. To date, there have been 9 women to fly solo around the world, as recently as 2017.